A whistleblower complaint in Rutherford County. It claims a top county official is breaking ethics rules, instructing staff not to do their jobs properly, and then costing the county much-needed tax dollars.
This is about property values and collecting taxes. Earlier today, WSMV4 investigative reporter Stacey Cameron spoke exclusively to that whistleblower, and he tells us those claims have now sparked two separate investigations.
No two houses are the same, but they all share one thing in common. Every year, their owners, like Jan Zylstra, pay property taxes.
Everybody pays a fair share.
Mowing the lawn of his Rutherford County home, Zylstra says he doesn't mind paying, knowing where his tax dollars go.
Schools.
But according to Richard Kincaid, some homeowners in Rutherford County may not be paying their fair share.
Immediately, I knew it was unethical and immoral.
Because for several years, he says property assessor Rob Mitchell allegedly pushed staff to conceal property assessment changes that would raise the current property tax bills on some homes, costing the county to lose out on an unknown amount of tax cash, according to Kincaid, who actually works as a property appraiser in Mitchell's office.
They are being cheated out of revenue, and the whole process is not being treated fairly.
Kincaid put his claims against Mitchell in this complaint filed with the Rutherford County Ethics Board and the State Comptroller's Office. We went to Mitchell's office to ask if he's directed staff to hide anything that would affect property tax values. Mitchell, who's running for re-election, says the allegations are politically motivated and he can't comment further due to ongoing county and state investigation. Finishing his yard up, Zylstra hopes the allegations are true.
We've got a lot of people coming in. We need the schools taken care of. Our teachers need to be paid.
Saying like his old mower, Rutherford County needs every fair property tax dollar it can collect to keep running.
The Rutherford County Ethics Board will take up Kincaid's complaint on July 17th. I'm told if they find any merits to that complaint, they can pass it along to the county attorney or the district attorney for further investigation into Mitchell's alleged conduct. For WSMV4, I'm investigative reporter Stacey Cameron.